Hey guys, this is a little bonus video I'm doing for you. Trying to figure out whether or not a reaction's spontaneous. I told you that a negative E cell is not spontaneous. What you may remember if you've taken any thermodynamics is that spontaneity is controlled by delta G. So delta G and E cell have to be related to each other somehow. And the answer is they are. Delta G equals negative nFE, where n is the number of electrons swapped in the reaction, F is the Faraday constant, and E is the E cell that we had figured out before. What you'll notice is that there's a negative out front here, which means that a positive E cell makes delta G negative. And according to thermodynamics, a negative Gibbs free energy will give you a spontaneous reaction. If E is negative here, this negative will cancel it out. Delta G will be positive. Positive delta G, positive Gibbs free energy means the reaction's not spontaneous. And that's why positive E cell means spontaneous. Negative E cell means not spontaneous. You could theoretically be asked what delta G is for a particular redox reaction. Now, we've figured out in a previous video that E cell for this reaction, how come I can't find it? E cell for this reaction is 0.78 volts. What is delta G? Well, delta G equals negative nFE, which is negative. Each time this reaction happens, we swapped two electrons. See, the copper gained two electrons. The iron lost two electrons. The lowest common multiple of those two is two. And so we're swapping two electrons each time. Oh, look. When you have your overall reaction, we cancel out two electrons on each side. That's probably the easier way to think about that. F is the Faraday constant, 96,485 coulombs per mole. This is the amount of charge that 1 mole of electrons carries with it. And my E, 0.78 volts. FYI, volts is the same as joules per coulomb. Take a look at what just happened, yo. Coulombs cancels out, moles cancels out, and I'm left with joules. Joules is how we measure Gibbs free energy. So all I need is my little calculatrice. Can you see what's happening on it? Kind of. 2 times 96,485. Times 0.78, and I make it negative, which means negative 150,517 joules, or really, basically negative 151 kilojoules. That is delta G for this reaction. And again, note, because delta G is negative, it's a spontaneous reaction as it's written here. Delta G and E cell are related by this equation. Know it. Best of luck.